Kudos for
saying. I hit the wrong fucking button. That's so kudos funny.
For hitting the wrong button.
For spilling.
Kudos for saying that, for hitting the wrong button. Okay, let's try that again. We're leaving this in. I don't care.
Look over here.
There we go. That's a little bit better. That's the kind of day we're having, y'all. If you watched the recap already, if you haven't, go watch the recap. That's just the kind of day we're having here today. But it is all good. But hello, bonjour, hi, and welcome to the Cup.
Well, rest in peace.
Look over here.
There it is. Our exclusive companion series. Our exclusive companion series where we are diving into the looks from episode 4 of season 2 of Canada's Drag Race Grave Original, Canada versus the World, season 2. I'm Logan Murphy. Say something gay. Gay. Wi-Fi is stupid today. I'm just drinking water. I have a cup mug. Y'all know where to get the link by now because I don't shut up about it.
Oh, yes. Well, my voice is absolutely gone. Hey, hello, I'm River, your Brazilian correspondent here on the Cup, and today I'm just still drinking water out of my same soccer team mug, my dad's favorite soccer team, so my voice, it's not really helping, the water, but
great.
I'll keep drinking.
Well, we're going to dive into the looks from the reading battles from this episode of Canada vs. the World. Before we do, make sure to subscribe if you're not already, because we're here almost all the time giving you almost all things drag. Check the description where you can find our audio podcasts, our other YouTube channels, and our Patreon for exclusive content and early access, including usually early access to the Look Over Here episodes for the Drag Race franchises we are currently covering. Boom. Shake hack. Boom. There we go.
Because reading is what?
Required at this podcast. Category is reading battles. I'm going to tell y'all right now, these are some of the worst photos for a slideshow I've ever done. Don't come for me. It's just, you know, that's the kind of day we're having here today at the Cup. So, first up, Miss Fiercelicious.
Mm-hmm. Best look of the night. I mean, look
best
at the material.
Best look of the night. Yeah.
I have to say this. The hair hat wig.
The hair girl. Hat wig on top of the hat hair wig.
Girl. Stupid. So good. I honestly don't have much negative to say. This was so good. She looked beautiful. I was mesmerized. If I do have to say something, it's just like I noticed when she was coming in. That like the boob area was a little bit like the proportion was a little bit small, but just like the tiniest bit, but it was noticeable. But other than that, this is just so good.
Yeah, I think this is definitely my favorite look of the night as well. I think Fierce looks really, really good. Where some girls kind of just did, you know, a leotard or a bodysuit, I'm glad that she at least came in a full look. The cape here is so good. The bodice is gorgeous. I love all of these like beige feathers coming out. It's monochromatic in the exact right way for me. The hat, hair, wig situation is so iconic to me. I love this. Fierce looks absolutely incredible. This is my favorite thing Fierce has worn this season.
I was going to say that. Yeah.
Mother Africa and then this.
Yeah. And also the shoe is perfect with like she thought about the shoes. So yeah, very detail oriented. So good.
I gave Fierce a 94.
I gave her a 97.
Next up, Lemon.
I love, like I oh, sorry, go ahead.
And I was trying to come up with a fruit that I could relate this to, but it's not blueberry, so just blue.
Yeah. I, like I said in the recap, I love the fact that they were, Lemon and Fierce were the only ones that coordinated their outfits. Like, they're not matching, but they, you can tell that they are in the same universe. And like, if it was a movie, you could tell that they were in the same movie. So I like that part from both of them. And also the fact that, to me, like, I think they had together the best look, but individually, I think it was Fierce, right? Because as much as I love this look on Lemon, one thing I do love this volume in the back. I just the place where it starts, where it's put, is kind of weird to me. But I don't mind that as much. The one thing that does throw me off though is the crotch part of this bodysuit, because the crotch was a little bit ill-fitting, but I don't know. I don't know if it was maybe because she lost or gained weight after doing the fitting for the outfit. That sometimes happens, but I could tell that there was issues with the crotch. But other than that, she looks really good. This hair with the headpiece also.
I don't always love a singular feather like this, but in this case, it does actually really, really work for me, and I'm not mad at it. Yeah, I agree. The fit issue was the only real issue I have with this, because otherwise the bodysuit is really cute. I love the glove, and I love just the mountains of tulle coming off of her body. Like, it's gorge. Lemon is gorge. Period.
And I love a monochromatic look.
So. Same. Mm-hmm. I gave Lemon a 90.
I also gave her a 90. Yeah.
Next up, Eureka.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll start with the positives. I love her hair and makeup. The proportion of this hair.
Some of the best hair I've ever seen. Her makeup is always,
like, she always has great makeup. The hair, I like, but it's a little hit or miss for me with Eureka. But this hair, I love. Love
her best
so much.
Hair in a while on Drag Race, I would say.
I think it was, for me, it was her best hair this season.
This for and sure. The loaf that she had for her design look last week. Mm-hmm. Those are my favorite hairs for her. But
yeah. And this outfit, I think, is fine. You know, like, it's as far as like a bodysuit kind of thing goes, it is a little bit more elevated than most. Is not that simple bodysuit, you know, like with the fringe and all of that. I do like that detail. But again, like the nude kind of thing, I couldn't tell if it was trying to be nude or if it was off-white.
I think it was supposed to be nude.
Yeah. And it was a little bit ill-fitting as well, at least that I could tell in the sleeve. It was bunching here
and
a
in
lot.
The leg. In the leg. Too.
And in the leg. Yeah. And like the thing is, if this was, for example, like a lip sync outfit, I would have nothing to say about it.
Gorge.
Literally. Because gorge. But like if they weren't going to have a runway for this challenge, I would have worn something different for this, you know?
Yeah.
But she doesn't look bad by any means. It's just, it's fine. It's literally just fine.
And that's kind of where I land with it, is it's just kind of fine. The hair and makeup is great. I don't like the nude illusion on this particularly. There's a bit of a, like, the fit issue with her breasts is a little weird as well. Like, they're kind of, like, folding over a little bit, which wasn't particularly my favorite thing to see. There's a bit of a fit issue in the leg, but I like the silhouette on her. I like the fringe that comes down over the puswacha. Like, all of that is really, really nice, but this was my least favorite look of the night because it's just kind of the most simple.
Mm-hmm. So, one thing I just thought about is Eureka is going through hormone therapy. So, yeah, I do understand that the fit issues might be because of weight fluctuating because of that. So, I get it. Yeah.
100%. I gave Eureka 75.
I give her a 70.
Next up is Cheryl, and I love this look from Chez.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do wish, as much as I do wish there was something on the bottom, like something. Even if she came with like high-waisted black like pantaloon pants, like very wide leg, but if it was like a slick black sequins.
Oh, okay.
And like that would have been so good. Like, yeah. It would have elevated it so much more to me. And it's not, it wouldn't be something like too complicated to like do. But the like waist up, love. So good. I love the concept as well, like that she went with something that when we look at it, we can tell that she's British. You know what I mean? Like, so.
What?
I like that.
She's so British. That was so shady from Brooke. Brooke was so dumb for that.
That gagged me, honestly.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite things Cheryl has worn this season, I'll be honest, because it is simple, but mm-hmm. it's very quintessentially Cheryl. She had her name on the back too, and I loved that detailing as well. Yeah, overall, the hair is good. The garment is good. It fits her perfectly. I like the little, like, tailcoat situation. I actually don't mind that it's just a fishnet leg. I'm not, like, the most upset about that. I see where you're coming from for sure with it, but I'm not mad at it.
It's just, I think it would have elevated it even more. Because for me, like, this is simple but effective and very polished, you know? But
yeah. I gave Cheryl a 92.
I gave her an 89.
Next up, Kennedy Davenport. Yes.
Mm-hmm. I feel very similar about this look as I did for Eureka. Because it's not a bad look. It's not, it's absolutely fine. I do like, similar to Eureka, like, the fringe is the moment of the outfit, for sure. One thing I do not like is this shoe. I don't like this shoe at all. Okay. Not with this outfit, at least. Like, just because I don't think it's an ugly shoe, it's just that where it cuts her leg, kind of, it just makes her really short. It just cuts her leg in a weird spot, but the actual outfit, I don't mind. I think it's fine. It's the same as Eureka. Like, if she was wearing this for a lip sync, I would have said, like, okay, I would have nothing to say about it. But exactly because they didn't have a runway, like, I would have worn something. Not necessarily something that would be, like, runway worthy, but a little bit more elevated than something I would wear for a lip sync. But she looks beautiful, so.
Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at with this. The reason I like this, I think, a little bit more than I liked Eureka's, is that this, I will say, this does look a lot more expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the stoning on
this part, like, is very nice.
I love the strapping along the, you know, the cutout I really like here. The patterning that happens on the side, I really do like that as well. This, like, kind of tan color. I don't feel like it's supposed to be a nude illusion. I don't get that from it. But this, like, tan and the
blue. No, I think it's just supposed to be that color. Yeah, it's not supposed to be trying to match the color of her skin at all.
Yeah. I really like this combination, though. I think it looks really, really fun on her. The hair is cute. It's a little flat, but I understand it given, you know, the fact that she had the gag in there, so I get it. But I'm not mad at this at all from Kennedy.
Yeah.
I gave Kennedy Davenport an 81.
And I gave her a sensible 74.
And last up, Alexis Mateo.
My second favorite look of the night.
Oh, wow.
Very closely followed by Lemon, but I did like Alexis' look more than I liked Lemon. Mostly because of this hair. Bitch. This hair.
The hair.
I'm obsessed. This is, it's so beautiful.
It's giving
and
a little
I
bit
love
of,
the dress as well.
It's giving a little Yana Sofia.
Yes. The two hoops. Yeah, yeah. Very. Very like
Yana,
everything everywhere
like
all at once.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very much the Yana Sofia maximalist style. Very much. One thing is for her skin tone, gold just is always gonna look so good. This is like very honestly very very close to perfection for me. I just the sleeves, I'm not the biggest fan of what's happening on the sleeve with the like the gold accents I like, but like I don't know, I didn't really love the sleeve, but I did not expect her to wear this for a challenge like this until I realized they didn't have a runway. Then I was like, okay, sure.
Yeah, I think it's a really good garment. It's a little, you know, the only thing I will say is that it is a tad predictable for Alexis, but I don't mind that at all. The gown fits her gorgeously. The hair is gorgeous. The makeup was a little exaggerated, and I don't particularly mind it. But overall, I think she looks real good. I gave Alexis an 88.
I gave her a 95.
Per. Mm-hmm. Well, that's that. World's quickest look over here episode. Yay.
I just wanted to mention that I think we did mention that kind of in the recap, but we're doing this because the girls didn't, they were told that. So here's, okay, let's circle back. So they didn't have a different runway for this challenge, but Fierce did say on Twitter that they walked the runway in these looks. But for her look specifically, for her runway walk, she had more on to that look.
Yeah.
So, and where I have a problem is the fact that production told the girls, allegedly, that's from Fierce Delicious. But allegedly, production told the girls that the runway was going to be shown. So that's where I have the problem of them not showing the runway. So that's why we wanted to do this episode to give the girls their flowers and the designers that worked hard on this looks, because they deserve it and everyone looked good, right?
Yeah,
even the people that we didn't like as much looked good. So they deserve it.
Yeah, definitely. So that is that. We're going to get out of here. Thank you for joining us for this episode of Look Over Here. We'll be back next week with more looks to look over there at. In the meantime, if you've not checked out our episode recap for this episode of Canada versus the World, make sure to go check that out. Subscribe, like, and share on your way out. Check out the description for our audio podcast links, our other YouTube channels, our Patreon, our social media, and where you can get your merch, including but not limited to cup mug. And with that, we're going to get out of here. So cheers.
Yes.
Hello, bonjour. Cheers. Bye.
Curious, delicious.
Par.